What up, my droogies? It's your boy, Gnarly Mark, aka Von Hohenheim, aka Zarathustra, aka the motherfucking lightning count. And I'm over here with
your boy, J-Kid, the motherfucking villain. You already know. I'm very, very, very friendly.
So word around the rumor mill is that we will be getting GameCube games on the Nintendo Switch Virtual Console.
Classics.
Apparently the likes of Mario Sunshine, Super Smash Bros. Melee, Luigi's Mansion, and Animal Crossing will all be announced by E3 of this year.
Mm-hmm.
With the GameCube being the first console that I actually ever owned, and so many jazzy memories of rocking out to so many of its games, I thought this would be the perfect time to list the top 5 GameCube games I want on the Switch Virtual Console.
Cinco!
5.
From the Mondo Tubular Yuji Naka, who also created Sonic, who also created Knights, we get Billy Hatcher and the Giant Egg. Now, Billy Hatch takes place in the mathematical world of Morning Land, where chickens run shit. Until one day, the Dark Raven shows up, starting some beef. It's up to Billy Hatch and his 4 white boy friends to go out there, obtain the power of the Giant Egg, and stop the Dark Raven from taking over Morning Land.
Chickens running the world, you already know.
Billy Hatcher came out at a time when people stopped playing platformers a lot and moved over to first-person shooters or whatever else was coming out at the time. But it was unique in that you maneuvered through the entire game with a giant egg. That egg pretty much gave you your power-ups, any moves that you could do. And after hatching the egg, you can unlock special helper characters, some of them even being Sonic, or Knights, or Choo Choo Rocket. It was dope in that it's a colorful game and it didn't make a big splash when it first came out. But I think if it came out today with the likes of Mario Odyssey coming out and Yooka-Laylee, I think it would make a bigger splash today than it did even back then.
But wait, didn't that game have multiplayer?
Word.
So, this is definitely a game that you can share with your friends.
Word, that's my line. So, G-Kid, what's your number 5 pick?
My number 5 pick? Put my beer down for this one, would have to be Star Fox Adventures. Woo! You already know, I have to put that in detail. You're going to a dinosaur adventure to meet Tricky, and then you're going to meet your girlfriend, your future girlfriend, your future waifu, Crystal. Fox, I hope you did bag that. I hope you did.
Word.
You are the hero in everyone's heart. You can fly a R-Wing like no other. After all the fucking adventure you went through, after all the staff hitting and egg collecting and trinket collecting as well, after all that, you're facing Andross again. Great move. Now I can assume that Andross is gonna be in every fucking game that you fucking put on, which is awesome because you would love to see that face, you know, just shooting at that face. Think of Star Fox Zero. But I like the adventure so far.
Yeah, I like Star Fox Adventure. It's like a Star Fox Zelda game.
Yeah. Pretty much.
Pretty much. It's like Ocarina of Time, but in space.
You also have to remember the salesman, the floating ghost dinosaur. Do you have any trinkets? Not enough scarabs! Doesn't he remind you of the guy from Resident Evil 4, who's the salesman
yeah,
as well?
He does.
You
know?
You don't have enough scarabs, stranger.
4.
Back in 2002, Capcom had announced they were developing 5 exclusive games for the Nintendo Cube. The company now known today as Crapcom actually went back on that deal, canceled one of them, left one exclusive, and imported the other 3 to the PlayStation 2. Thanks, Crapcom.
Don't you ever disrespect Sony again, and y'all motherfuckers better not do it either.
It would be impossible to deny that out of that deal we got some Mondo Tubular games, one of them being Beautiful Joe. Beautiful Joe is developed by the Playboys that will later on become Platinum Games. It's a 2D side-scrolling beat-em-up with 3D comic book graphics. Now at the time, they weren't making too many 2D games, or the people that would become Platinum Games, infused it with so much style that they made something old new again. And Beautiful Joe wears its homages with pride. It wears its influences with so much fucking pride, from American action movies, to comic books, to Japanese teketatsu television shows. Hell's fucking bells, even his super moves are named after cinema techniques. You got the fast forward. You got the zoom in. You got the slow motion. It's a fucking tragedy that Big Joey never showed up on the PSN or Xbox Live Virtual Console. Yes, he showed up in MBC3, but the dude deserves more. And this would be the moment to definitely bring back Big Joey on the Switch Virtual Console. Boom.
Big Joey is definitely one of those genre of games that you want to pick up. My number four pick would have to be from the great guys of Namco. Soul Calibur 2. Oof. Oof.
Guns and butter, baby. Oof. Guns and butter.
You already have your star player in Soul Calibur 2 as a guest character. And I'm talking about the legendary Link. The Soul Calibur brand has upgraded their form of fighting games to a new level. And Soul Calibur 2 brings that. You have upgraded weapons. You had a dungeon mode. You had story mode. You had great soundtracks. What more can you say about Soul Calibur 2? It needs to be done on the Switch portable. Why not bring it to the Switch? Soul Calibur 2, Link.
Valdo. That's Valdo. All I gotta say. That's all I gotta say.
Valdo was an annoying character. He's
also three.
Another game that came out of Capcom's exclusive deal with Nintendo was Killer 7. Killer 7 would mark the first time that I was introduced to God tier creative mind Goichi Suda, more commonly known as Suda 51. I'm the type of dude that I can play a game that most people usually wouldn't like, so long as it has a lot of style, like a Willy Wonka amount of style. And Goichi Suda has style avalanching out of the fucking wazoo. You can pay for class, but you can't buy style. I'm not even worthy of speaking on behalf of this game. Just watch the fucking B-roll.
Now, wasn't that style more of a GoldenEye feeling?
No.
No? When you had multiplayer on there?
No.
No?
No.
No?
Hello, darkness, my old friend.
I apologize for the statement. And I will never do it again.
Dickhead, what is your number three pick?
Number three pick will be Metal Gear Solid Twin Snakes. Psych! You think Konami's gonna get this credit? Hell no. That number three spot is gonna get Metroid Prime. I would love to replay that game again. I think it would be a nice portable game. You find mysteries and clues, and you could also roll up into a little ball and just go through little platforms, and you get rockets. You get amazing monsters that appear into the game. Bless you. fight boss battles that are intriguingly hard, I believe, because I heard that that game was really hard to maneuver. So, I would love to see a Metroid Prime series onto it. Not just one, two, three as well. I would love to master the game, and I will definitely play it on Villainy Games when it comes out here. And you comment, like, and subscribe, but we'll get that to the end.
I remember my time with Metroid Prime, and man, what an amount of detail and effort these guys in Texas put into a Japanese creation.
Texas?
God bless you, Retro Studios. You guys created a masterpiece.
Bless you. Thank you. You are so good.
It was something of a homecoming when Squeenix put Final Fantasy Crystal Chronicles on the queue after jumping ship from Nintendo to Sony with Final Fantasy VII.
Yeah, what did I tell you?
You don't want him to come back.
No. I know what you're going to ask me if you played this game. I can't even begin to think of a way to make this happen. But if they could, and somehow make it easier for four people to play together, that would be so fucking righteous. I still have memories of packing up my Game Boy SP with my Game Boy Link cable, with my GameCube memory card, and making that voyage to my homie's casa. And Tom cruising our way of Mount Kalanda just to roll that Iron Giant for the 100th time.
I would love to experience Final Fantasy Crystal Chronicles. I heard it was a great game, and it was hard to find. gather three of my friends up. I think I have three here.
We have there, but we need three Game Boys, three link cables, and three memory cards.
I think we could pull that off.
I can dig it.
Mi número dos, my number two, would have to be Kirby's Air Ride. Kirby's Air Ride is a 60 FPS driving experience with your shooting star. It's everything that you would have put together like F-Zero and Mario Kart in a Kirby game. It's a great racing experience on this game. Wouldn't you agree?
I didn't like that game. Let's go to our honorable mentions.
What is numero uno, number one for you, Gnarly Marv?
In the late 90s, early 2000s was like the golden age of the JRPGs. But the GameCube barely got to eat off of that table. But when it did eat off that table, it had a feast. I'm talking about Tales of Symphonia, Evolution Worlds, Batten Kaitos.
Pretty good.
Paper Mario 2.
Ooh.
Skies of Arcadia. Legends. If you think back to that time, you notice that every single JRPG was either trying to reinvent the wheel or raise the bar for what the genre could be. Sega was like, fuck that. We're just gonna make a solid RPG experience. And that's what they did.
Yeah.
And that's why I loved them.
Me too.
At the time, not anymore. There's no emo bozo with a giant overcompensating sword. There's no blank face with choices that don't matter. No. You got this upbeat space pirate named Vise with his colorful cast of homies helping him to defeat an evil empire who's trying to use ancient weapons of mass destruction with the likelihood of destroying the entire world. A basic story, no doubt, but something that Sega did right with this game is that they made every single element of this game so solidly. Probably the game that has aged the most in terms of graphics and gameplay, but you'd be hard pressed to find a more solid JRPG experience from the GameCube era of games. It was a Dreamcast game first, after all.
Now, that would be dope. Just playing a portable. It would be dope.
It'd be righteous to be able to play a game of that scale on the go.
It's like playing Final Fantasy, any Final Fantasy game portable.
It's better than Final Fantasy.
And it's better, yes. It's better than Final Fantasy. It's definitely way better. My number uno pick. My number uno pick would have to be, and I don't like to give Mario credit, I really don't, but there's other rosters as well. Mario Kart Double Dash! So far, the best racing game that you could ever play on a GameCube. Why? Two teams! Switch them between items, stars, blue shells! And you get your own cart.
And you can fucking punch people.
Exactly! Who doesn't want that?
Come on, beer.
You want my beer?
No. Oh yeah.
Okay. Doesn't want that. The graphics on it. It's so great on it. And especially for GameCube games. And they're well known for good graphics. You know, Nintendo knows their shit when they made the GameCube. You know, you have games like Melee. You have games like,
Day of Reckoning.
Wind Waker, Day of Reckoning. You know, you have all those games. But you want that one racing game. That one racing game. Sorry, Mighty Peep. I know you're expecting something else, but Double Dash. Double Dash is one of the greatest racing games I've ever played in my entire life. I had to pick Yoshi or Luigi. Now I can have them both in the same cart. How dope is that?
Luigi!
You got Luigi versus Yoshi! And it's amazing. Remember those games, friend? Remember the racing?
I like the game. I hate the blue shells. Oh, but the babies were my favorite because their special move was the chain chop.
The babies! The babies,
the
man!
The chain chop will always put you in first place.
Hell yeah.
I dig that.
Fuck Mario Kart 8! Mario Kart Double Dash! For the virtual console! Yeah. You need it now! Right?
Yeah!
Make sure you like, share, and subscribe. Turn on notifications.
Yes.
Whatever you want us to talk about next in Troy, make sure you leave it in the comments and let us know. I'm motherfucking Naughty Marv.
And I'm J-Kid, the friendly villain.
And we are Villainy Games, and this is Troy.